Welcome to Lake Erie Wrestling. I'm Jake Young here, and with my broadcast partner, Steven Giuseppison, we're here again. We're going to take you down to the contract signing for the tournament to determine the first two title holders. This is the signing of the contract. All the superstars are going to be signing, the ones that are participating in the event. So without further ado, here we are.
I am not going to be the first to sign this, so
why not?
Well, you see, after I beat him, you see, I am going to be the last man. I'm going to have this title. So therefore, it sees fit that I sign it last.
Well, you see, you talk big game, so
yeah,
I figured.
Yeah.
Why?
Come
why
on,
me?
Man.
Wait,
just sign, sign the
why,
damn
why
paper.
Me first?
Do it, man. It's okay.
What?
Spell your name.
You need help. Ask me.
A bit unnecessary.
There, I signed it first. Hey.
Give him his hat back.
Come on.
All right, enough.
Hey, what are trying to do?
Trying to have just legitimate.
Come on, sign it.
No, I don't believe in signing order have anything to do with who wins the match. Because my name is Alex Daniels, and I'm going to win either way, whether I sign first, last, second, third, eighth, seventh. I'm going to win. I am Alex AGD Daniels, and let me tell you what AGD stands for.
Ginger.
Alex Greatness Daniels. And I'm going to sign this contract, and I'm going to beat every man who comes in my path, and I'm going to take this LEW title, put it around my waist, and raise my own hand as LEW champion.
Great speech.
Who are you, and what are you doing in my living room?
Who the hell let this guy in?
Excuse me?
Hey!
Oh, yeah.
Oh, another no name.
I guess I'll go next.
All right.
No name on the list, buddy. No name? Better hustle combat. Better hope you don't get in the ring with me.
Oh, good luck.
There you go. He deserves it.
Yeah, he does.
Doesn't
he? Come on.
Make sure you write that in American, man.
Ding dong, ding dong, ding dong.
Has everyone signed yet?
No.
What is that?
No,
what are you doing?
He's in the
tournament?
Guys.
No,
who do you think you are?
Should I sign my chair?
I'm Matt McFly.
Is that my shirt?
What are you trying to
do?
Hey, what are you doing? Stop.
Oh, is everyone done?
Am I last?
Stop being kind.
Can Eminem finally signed it?
Save the worst for last.
Sign first the tap.
Pussy bitch.
Good job.
Wait, what's your shitty?
Oh, alright. Make sure the Asian knows how to spell the redneck
and
right.
Yeah, I know how to
write the name. Yeah, man, okay. Whatever you
say,
now, when I get my hands on this title, you see, you can all...
I mean this belt. It's gonna be mine, okay?
Me mine.
Don't rip it, come on.
I'm done with this shit.
Oh my goodness. It's breaking out into brawl. We gotta get someone down here. Oh man, this strike. Oh my goodness, speared on that steel table. Alex Daniels and Jonathon Soul, getting really angry, but Jonathon, oh man, thrown over that table. Oh, kicked in the gut. Matt McFly, oh my god. Look at the power of Ash Mercury. Oh my god, he just slammed Tyler Phoenix on his back. Alex Daniels has a title here. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, kick right.
Oh, my God.
Oh, man. Just shoved down when he tried to grab that title by Josh. He's pushing through people. Soul hits Ash Mercury. Oh, man. What's the KO doing? Oh, wow. We had to cut right through there. We cannot watch any more of this. We can't let it go. Now, our first match for tonight is going to be an exhibitional match between this man right here, Jihad. He is the Prince of Arabia, looking to represent his nation with his father, Habibi, at his side. What do you think of this character right here?
Reminds me about being in Russia.
I don't really understand that metaphor here. What is this? Habibi just ordered our standard official out of the ring. It looks like this match has just became a special referee match. Oh my goodness, I do not like the looks of this. And this man right here is no pushover, I can guarantee you that. Coming in all the way from Asia is Takeo. He was trained by the great wizard, Saka Yakamori. The intensity right here, you can tell it. You can see it in his little squinty eyes.
He's a submission specialist.
Jihad.
Let's get ready to rumble!
National wrestling champion. The lock up here. He has a headlock, it's Takeo. Oh man, look at the raw power of the German suplex there, going for a cover. A very fast count. He's moving him into some kind of submission there, some kind of rubber guard. Habibi is trying to encourage Takeo to give up here. And ordering his son to try a different move here. Oh, great. He's got double arm hooks, stretching the body of Takeo. He gives up. Proceeds to ground and pound the back of the head of Takeo. Oh my god. The impact of those strikes, that's just pure dirty. We need a real ref in here.
This is unfair, this is his father.
Oh man, just whipping him back with another big German suplex and trying to go for a cover.
No, I want you to make him suffer.
Habibi ordering his son to make him suffer, but what is this?
No!
Oh man.
Rope break!
Oh man.
He got the rope!
There's no rope! He's calling for a rope break! He didn't grab the rope!
He got the rope!
This is just not right, and Takeo knows it.
He got the rope!
Oh my god!
He killed him! He killed him!
Did you see the power of that whip? He just whipped him across the damn mat!
Hurt him!
Oh, he's stretching him out again. Look at the contorted body of Takeo!
He got the rope!
Oh my god. Look at that! Just pure power there.
One.
Takeo looks to be out here, but this isn't fair. There's no shame in losing. What?
Takeo reverses.
Oh my goodness, the energy. Look at the pure transition power. He's fluid.
Fight him.
Oh man. But Jihad's picking him up again. Oh, but he counters right into a pin.
One, two.
Ah, but he counters out. Look at this. Let's look at the fluency of the transition here by Takeo. Just beautiful. That's how you can see that he is definitely a submissions expert. Oh my goodness. Look at the power of Takeo! Slamming him right down. But oh my god, no. Jihad counter right into a sleeper hold.
Seamlessly.
That just goes to show. Jihad has always got his head in the game.
With an equal match, you have submission specialist Takeo and wrestler Jihad.
See, but what makes this match not equal, the differential in this match, is purely Habibi being the special referee.
No, you're hurting him. Let him go.
Habibi letting go, ordering Takeo to let go of his son because he was hurting him. Oh my god, a brutal knee to the face of Jihad.
This is so stupid, Jihad.
And Habibi is insulting him.
No.
Chris has got a huge headlock there, but the ref breaks it up. This is so unfair.
How does Takeo expect to win?
He won't live.
Oh my god. Oh my god. But what is this? They're locking up here. Locking up with a pro wrestler, but oh my god, he's got a sleeper hold. Oh my God. And he's got the, he's going to go for that standard Kimura. He's going to, oh my God, he's got it locked in. Jihad could be in severe trouble here. He's telling him to let him go, but Takeo won't. That's a tap out. This match is over. Takeo won. Against all odds, goddammit, Takeo pulled out the victory. And I'm just about stunned as anyone could be.
He has the luck of Buddha.
The luck of Buddha is on his side. There's no doubt about it. That's what happens when you train so hard. Oh my God. Oh my God. Habibi's having a temper tantrum. He heaves his son across the damn ring through the ropes. Climbing out of the ring, his son. He knows he failed his father. His father's chasing him. Oh my God. Man. This next match is a tournament match here. Clyde Steel will be taking on Cliff Bearden, a man who has no background in wrestling whatsoever. He just came in off the streets and I guess LEW management decided that it would be a good idea to let him in just to, you know, throw some meat into the roster.
Let's see what Mr. Bearden has in him.
Oh my. He's riding a bicycle, it seems. Oh my God. Look at this crazy bastard. He's making motorcycle noises. They must not have done a mental health check on him. What do you think, Giuseppe?
There is no background check in LAW.
Huh. The bell's rung. What the hell?
Twisting and contorting like a dead fish.
Screaming that there's voices in his head, but oh my God, he's chasing Clyde Steel! Ooh, right into a Russian sweep. Oh my God. Oh, slamming him down. Drops the elbow right on the heart. Oh no, but look at the counter. Clyde Steel, like an anaconda. Oh, he's got him back up. Judo headlock hip toss!
One,
he's got him.
Two.
Oh, but Cliff Bearden manages to kick out of that.
Certainly there an ability with Cliff Bearden.
Yeah, for a nobody, I'd say. Coming in right off the streets. Northern Lights flipping suplex. Look at the agility of Clyde Steel.
How beautiful and seamless.
They're staring each other down here. Looks like a test of strength. Oh, man! Did you see that beautiful clothesline from hell by Cliff Bearden?
He nearly knocked his head off.
I do not believe that there is no wrestling experience for him as he hits a double-arm DDT. He obviously knows his way around this ring. Oh, man. Looking for a submission, but Clyde Steel manages to come to his senses and kick him off of him. Oh, super big sidewalk slam there.
Clyde Steel brain at work.
Clyde Steel is obviously very proud of himself. You can hear him talking, and he's got him on those huge rags. Samoan drop right on the inner core.
How is he going to survive that?
I don't know, Giuseppe. I really don't. Oh, look at that knee to the head. Striking him. Oh, God. Oh, my God. Oh, suplex with a neck breaker attached and a bridging pin, but he finds a way to kick out here. Cliff Bearden is really showing some impressive resiliency against an obvious veteran in Clyde Steel. Pushing him into the ropes, going for clothesline. He dodges it. Oh, a jawbreaker. Oh, my goodness.
You don't see that every day.
You don't, but you know what? Oh, man. He just speared that damn ref. That official's down. Dick Johnson's been speared. Oh, my God. He's going for it. Oh, what an impressive slam there from Cliff Bearden. He's really surprising me right now. This could be the end of Clyde Steel, but oh, this is dirty. He's climbing himself out of that ring. Oh, man. What's going to happen next? Climbing out of the ring. Oh,
my God.
He just hit him with a weapon. This isn't legal.
The referee's knocked out, though.
Oh my God, he just brashed that aluminum sheet over the head of Cliff Bearden. Oh man, flipping him.
If he didn't have brain damage now,
he definitely does. I agree with you. Giuseppe, I definitely agree.
My word, 10 points.
I'd say, oh man. Oh man, he's going for that signature commendium. It looks like wrenching the hell out of the arm of Cliff Bearden. Dear Lord. Oh, God, he's got it locked in. This is it. Look at the lateral agility.
Look at that impact.
He spun him like a rag doll, and that is it. Just like that, Clyde Steel moves on in the Lord of the Ring tournament. He does does not look surprised at all at the victory here. He looks a little bit more concerned about the mental health and stability of the man who just fought. Busting a move right there and saying he's going to have a title. Another tournament match. This is Jonathon Soul here. He'll be taking on Tyler Phoenix one-on-one. This should be a decent match. They lock up. Look at that. Look at the fluency. Making the great transition, technically. Oh, man. Getting right to behind. He's got the rat. Oh, my God. He's got the head. He's got the headlock cinched in. But twisting the arm. Look at the technical skill of both of these men. Matching the arm, but he's got the arm now. Giuseppe, what do you think about this action?
I think it's great technical wrestling.
I'd say that's just about as obvious of a quote as you could put out there. A great clothesline there. Oh, man. Look at the lateral agility. Oh, dodging that. Drop kick, sweeping it right out. Roll a pin. Here, this could be it. Oh, Soul kicks out right there. Oh my. Stuck in the clothesline. Whoa! Oh my goodness!
Sunset flip!
He sunset flip. Wait, there's a counter! Counter!
Come on!
Just double one counts there. I'm a little disappointed. Oh my God!
They're putting on a clinic.
Two!
I thought that was gonna be it. That super kick tagged him right on the chin. Dropping that elbow pad or knee pad and dropping the raw knee on the face of Soul. Making sure there's no padding to soften up on his cheekbones.
Gonna make him taste that knee.
One,
I'd say he just
two.
About could. He sure tasted the knee, but it didn't kill him as he's still in this thing, kicking out of a two count. Picked up into the ropes and sidewalk slam all the way up atop of those 6 foot nine shoulders of Tyler Phoenix, but he kicks out. What the hell? The Soul in Soul, no pun intended, is incredibly bright tonight. Lifting all the way up on that rack, but he counters out and reversal. He's lifting him up on those little shoulders. That's a lot of weight. Oh my God.
Look at that impact.
He hits him with the Soul powerbomb. Oh my God, he kicked out.
How did he do that?
This is the most surprising match. I figured it'd already be over by now, considering these are two supposed nobodies in this ring. This has turned into your technical dream match. Hits him with a huge dropkick, knocking Tyler Phoenix right into that lower turnbuckle. Pulling him in, going for another cover of Soul.
One, two.
Pushing him out, and I've kind of come to the realization here that it's going to take a big move to put down either one of these men. I'm not expecting a pinfall here because the heart inside each of these men is obviously big and showing tonight. Huge strike there from Soul. Another big strike. Oh my God! The stinging sound of that enziguri must have rang the ears in the brain. He rattled him dearly.
One, two.
But he still finds a way to kick out.
How is he doing this?
Where is he digging?
He's digging down deep from the Soul. No pun intended, but Soul has the biggest Soul in LEW.
Guiding up Tyler Phoenix.
Going for the Soul Cutter. Pushed off. Oh, my sweet Jesus.
That's it. That's it.
That was it. That was the most devastating super kick I've ever seen.
Another kick out.
I'm speechless here. I do not know what to say. I am literally speechless. As he heaves him out of that ring, caught up on the ropes a little bit, but he threw him hard enough to just about push right through anything. Found his way to the ground. Bending him over on that rail, going for that signature double kick. Hits him with the first. Will he get him with the... Oh, he tags him right in the face. Oh, my God. Whisper in the wind!
He killed him! He killed him!
He just about smashed his brain! He just about smashed Soul's brain! Soul is obviously writhing in pain as Tyler Phoenix crawls over to his downed opponent.
Gotta throw him back in the ring.
He's gotta get the pin here. I'd say that's just about it for Soul.
Is it too much time? Will the soul prevail inside of Jonathon Soul?
One, two.
And it does! I'm just about speechless at this point. What about you, Giuseppe?
I'm a man of few words.
Right on, Giuseppe. See, my name's Jacob Young. Once again, for those of you who don't know, welcome to LEW, Lake Erie Wrestling Thrashzone.
One, two, three.
No! He kicked out! The referee is signaling that it was a two count.
Arguing with the referee.
Oh my God, Tyler Phoenix is pissed off. And he's a real good guy once you get to know him. It takes a lot to piss him off. He's pissed. Throwing him into that turnbuckle. Look at that!
That has to be it.
The vertical slam. Spinebuster. Sit down, Spinebuster. Soul kicks out again. I don't think that anything's going to put him down.
Take.
He better be planning on wearing him down with this submission, because there's no way Soul's going to give up. He can't even be pinned, damn it.
You give up.
Soul fights out of it, kicking him right off.
What's Soul going to come up with now?
Soul finds his way to his feet. Oh my God. Soul cutter. No. Oh my God. He caught him in crossbody. Oh,
slam.
The follow-away slam right into the ropes of Jonathon Soul. Jonathon Soul still kicks out. You know, if Jonathon Soul can keep up this kind of self-morale, I don't think anyone's going to be able to stop him. Because obviously, pulling out all the stops here is Tyler Phoenix. He can't even keep him down for a damn three count. Oh, set up for that Hearst donut. This will do it. What? Oh, my God. Gut kick. Picking him up here. Catatonic right onto that knee, so it's a backbreaker here, and he's picking him up. What a combination there. Mic check, one, two.
One, two.
Oh, my God. Tyler Phoenix, he fights just as much as Jonathon Soul here.
We might have a draw here.
Yeah, if these men don't die before one of them gets pinned, I'd be surprised damn near killing each other in this ring. This is just such an intense week of LEW. With a humongous enziguri, and that'll bring the giant down to his knees. Oh, going for the soul cutter, he's pushed off. Oh, God. The Hurt Donut. No! What the hell? Pushed off again. Both men are dying to get their finishers here. Tyler Phoenix hits another devastating super kick. He's got that cinched in. Oh, my God, he fights out of it again. Soul cutter! Oh, my Jesus! He hit him with the damn soul cutter! Oh,
one,
God!
Two, three.
He just like that! One, two, three, Jonathon Soul will be moving on in the Lord of the Ring Tournament, dear God! The soul of Jonathon Soul really prevailed in that matchup! Oh, my God! Put your hands together for Tyler Phoenix, though, folks. He had a big soul, too, but it's not enough to conquer the soul's willpower of Jonathon Soul!
Lucky I do not beat your ass right here.
Excuse me.
What do you want?
Mr. Habib, what are your guys' opinions on that match?
Speak for yourself. Go on, talk.
It was a disappointment.
It was more than a disappointment. But that did not show the skill level of my son, Jihad. He is the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be. There is no Bret Hart in the WWE. That is the most overrated organization in the world. We're doing this for our homeland of Afghanistan, and we are going to prove we are the best.
Do you think his nationality has anything to do with his superior wrestling skills?
Yes. We are the proudest, finest people in the land.
Well, thank you.
Yes. Still can't believe you lost.
Excuse me, Tyler Phoenix.
Yeah.
Can I have your opinions on the match you just had?
I'm not gonna lie. I'm a little surprised that I lost in the opening round of the championship tournament tonight. But I just couldn't get the job done, and I have no shame losing to Jonathon Soul. He's a great wrestler, and I have a lot of respect for him. So.
Excuse me, Clyde Steel.
Yep.
Can I have your opinion on your match with Cliff Bearden?
My opinion. Before I give you my opinion on the match, let me give you my opinion on the character I faced. This man, Cliff Bearden, what the hell is wrong with this dude? Does LEW have no standard? This guy very well could have wandered in from the cold looking for a place to sleep and or looking for crack. I am not playing with you here. That man is a threat.
You look into his eyes, and it's like you're looking at a blank wall. Except this blank wall wants to kill you. Okay? I kicked his ass, expectedly enough. But the intimidation factor there was high. I mean, next person to meet in the ring with this guy, if they don't hold their own, I wouldn't be surprised if this guy tries to kill them. Kill them!
Excuse me, Jonathon Soul, can I have your opinions on the match you just had with Tyler Phoenix?
Tyler Phoenix. Let me tell you this. He is one of the greatest competitors that I've ever stepped in a ring with. See, it was my debut tonight, and now that I had a great match with him, I will tell you this, that I will have a great match with all of the other LEW roster, because I'm just that good.
Excuse me? Cliff? Can I have your opinion on your match with Clyde Steel?
Clyde Steel. There's so many things I could say about Clyde Steel. But before I talk about that, I want you all to get to know me. Me, Cliff Bearden. See, I'm a very sensible, intelligent, and logical man when I'm taking my medicine. See, I take oxycodone every day, and it helps all these funny little levels in my head go right so I can keep sanity in this world of insanity. But come to think of it, did I take my medicine today? Well, no. I came to LEW, and I woke up, but I woke up before I came to LEW. And then, you know, come to think of it, I didn't take my medicine today. And I'm a little bit pissed off about how Clyde Steel likes to handle his matches. Win dirty? Next time I see you, Clyde Steel, you're getting a fucking wrench to the head. That's enough of my time.